So it's a while already that I was investigating into CPM when this IBM PC XT played dead on me. Out of nowhere there was suddenly this characteristic smell of burned electronics in the air, and of course it wouldn't react anymore when triggering the power switch. I had the impression the smell came from the power supply, and after taking everything apart, I found this. Have you ever fixed an old computer? I did, many times. I'm the vintage collector, and these are my stories. So what we see here is a RIFA capacitor. Well, no, it's actually not, at least not the one that should belong here. I obtained this IBM XT from a basement clearance 18 months ago, and along with it, I took these handwritten notes by the deceased pre-owner. His notes dating to October 1st, 2013 explained that he had the clicking noise on the power supply and the smell of electronic burn. He then swapped the original RIFAs rated at 0.1 microfarad and 275 volts by these Philips capacitors. Now, RIFA was a Swedish manufacturer of electronic components, and these so-called RIFA capacitors are there to filter out line interference. It's not uncommon to see these failing, as generally, old capacitors tend to fail over time. Now, the pre-owner clearly put in higher spec caps, which is generally just fine. But honestly, the way they look, I'm tempted to believe that he didn't take new ones, but any such that were salvaged themselves from elsewhere. Say what you want, but I'm gonna swap them out against some modern day's replacement X2 capacitors. So after sitting around for 18 months, I finally took the plunge to look into it. In order to swap the RIFAs, I anyways had to disassemble the entire power supply. So while I was on it, I thought to swap all electrolytic caps along with it as well. Now, I had to swap caps 2 years ago on an IBM CGA CRT monitor, so I was hoping to find a matching caps kit on console 5. But no, they don't have one. Hence I was looking around on -0degrees.net if there was a schematic for the power supply. If anything, I can only recommend you to go through -0degrees.net as it provides the best online source about these old IBM machines. Luckily, he had some schematics, so I took the time to compare them against the actual PCBs I had, and I noted down all caps I needed. I didn't have all of them on stock, so eventually I received a whole bunch of caps so I could start with the endeavor. But let's not forget about our sponsor today, PCBWay. I had the opportunity to partner with PCBWay and go into deep with their 3D printing services. Although a simple knob, it helped me to restore the appearance of this compact portable. Likewise here on another compact machine with a spare trim panel. What about the SGI-02 with a beautiful reproduction of the power supply cover and the drive sled? And although it belongs to my sister channel and that video hasn't actually been published yet, but look at these 3D printed parts I used for building a scale model of Kit's semi. So if you need services, maybe PCBWay can help you. And now, up to the soldering part. One thing to note about old solder. It's quite common that it tends to not melt properly and just clings. One should apply some solder flux then, but nah, note to myself, buy some new solder flux. But you can also get away by simply reapplying some fresh solder with a flux core. This will help most of the time as the flux of the fresh solder is typically good enough to motivate old solder to reflow as well. Eventually, I had swapped all caps, so I had set up this minimalistic diagnostics configuration, which basically is just the power supply, the mainboard and the speaker. At first, you do it without the graphics card, also setting the DIP switches accordingly, just to see if it powers up. Hearing the power supply spin and the series of beeps, which indicate that no graphics card is installed, is already a positive indicator, as this is what we expect here. So I tested it once again with the graphics adapter installed, and voila! I guess I can reassemble it now. Once I had put back in the power supply and the mainboard into the chassis, I was thinking to do another test. While it had first turned on, it shut down just moments later. Although I neither heard or saw a spark, I had the impression seeing some smoke coming out of one of the tantalum capacitors back there. So I went on to replace more capacitors. What I did note during my repair, that this one here, which is as well a well-known candidate for failing, had been replaced already, albeit by two, not by one. Again, looking at the notes of the pre-owner, he had recorded that he had replaced said capacitor. Anyway, I'm gonna do it again. Once I have put back everything, I'm up for another power on test.
What's up?
Yeah, I wondered that myself. Again, it's not powering up. If you watch closely, you can see how the fan in the power supply quickly spins. So I can't help it, I'm about to remove all expansion boards and try one by one. I think one of them has a short. Ah yes, we're coming closer, it clearly spins up now. It seems to be the serial power port causing the harm, so when I plug it back, the machine won't power up. It too has tantalum caps, and even without going into measuring it all, it's most likely they just had failed. So let's do another swap round. And here comes the moment of truth. Fantastic! It powers on. How awesome is that? And during my testing, it all looks just good and functional. Albeit the hard drive sounds a bit unhealthy, it still boots straight away into CPM, just exactly where I left off the machine during my video 18 months ago. So let's pack it all up. The museum awaits you. And here we are with the IBM PC XT, which is all up and running again. The pre-owner also had this copy of an ad originally published in the German magazine Spektrum der Wissenschaft, dating to 1983. It reads like an anachronism when claiming the IBM PC to be small, handy and powerful. Even more so when comparing to a modern day's ultra portable machine like this one here. But 45 years ago, these bulky machines were indeed the microcomputers of the day, and they laid the foundation for our present day technology. So, what's next on TPC? I'm totally not into printers, but I managed to obtain this bulkhead here nevertheless. Do you say hey, or do you say nay? Or rather delve into a good fusion between hobby and nerdism, which is this bricks building set by Fantasy, replicating a classic 90s desktop PC. Let me know in the comments below. I'm the vintage collector, and this was my story for today. Thanks for watching, and see you again next Sunday.